Did you know that Down syndrome is one of the most common genetic disorders affecting millions of people worldwide? And that it's been depicted in historical paintings as far back as the 15th and 16th centuries? In this informative video, we'll take you on a journey to better understand Down syndrome and how it impacts the lives of individuals and their families. As we unravel the mystery behind this unique condition, we'll explore its causes, characteristics, and the everyday challenges faced by those who have Down syndrome. If you're a caregiver, a friend, or simply someone interested in learning more, this is a video you won't want to miss. By the end, you'll be better equipped to support and care for someone with Down syndrome and appreciate the extraordinary lives they lead. So, let's dive in and discover the world of Down syndrome together. Down syndrome is a genetic disorder affecting the chromosomes. Chromosomes are tiny structures that are present in every cell of our body. They contain densely grouped genetic information about all the characteristics of a human being. In other words, they pack up the genetic code that determines who a human being is going to be, what they'll look like, and how their body is going to function. Humans normally have 23 pairs of chromosomes, numbered from 1 to 22. Plus one pair of sexual chromosomes that determines our biological sex. Each pair is made up of one chromosome that you got from your mother and one chromosome that you got from your father. So let's say a man and a woman decide to have a baby. Each of them would contribute 23 chromosomes, hence the embryo or baby will have 23 pairs of chromosomes, adding up to 46 chromosomes in total. However, it might happen that one of the parents passes on an extra chromosome, so 24 instead of 23. If the extra copy is of chromosome number 21, then the baby will have three copies of chromosome 21, one inherited from one parent and two mistakenly inherited from the other. This is called trisomy 21, which literally translates to three copies of chromosome 21. This is what you might otherwise know as Down syndrome. Like we already mentioned, Down syndrome is one of the most common genetic disorders of the world. For every 1,000 babies born alive, it is estimated that one will have Down syndrome. However, this frequency varies a lot, depending on several factors. For instance, it is known that the mother's age at the time of the pregnancy plays a significant role. As a woman gets older, her chances of having a baby with Down syndrome increases. In women aged 45 or older, for example, for every 30 to 35 pregnancies, one baby will be born with Down syndrome. You might have already noticed that people with Down syndrome look a little bit different than people with a typical chromosome count. This is because the extra copy of chromosome 21 alters the course of development and causes some different physical features, although the degree to which these features are present can vary widely among individuals. When a baby with Down syndrome is born, these differences in appearance may be very subtle, and you might not even notice anything is unusual. Even so, most of them will at least have a few of the following characteristics: low muscle tone or hypotonia, which can make them appear floppy, upward slanting eyes, a flattened face, particularly in the nose and mid-face area, small ears which are typically set lower on their head, a single crease across the palm called transverse palmar crease or simian crease instead of the usual two creases seen in typical babies, a short neck with excess skin folds, a wide gap between the first and second toes, also known as sandal gap, and an inward curvature of the pinky finger, which is known as fifth finger clinodactyly. Remember, not all newborns with Down syndrome will exhibit all of these features, but most will have one or a few of them. Aside from the differences in appearance, living with Down syndrome presents a unique set of daily challenges. Almost all people with Down syndrome will have mild to moderate intellectual disability, even though the degree of impairment can vary a lot. They can often do things on their own, however, most need supervision throughout their lives. In fact, Down syndrome is the most common form of intellectual disability in the world. Due to language and speech difficulties, people with Down syndrome might have trouble expressing their thoughts and feelings, leading to frustration or misunderstandings. Social situations can also be challenging. Although they are often able to engage socially, people with Down syndrome might struggle to understand social cues or interpret emotions, which can lead to feelings of isolation or exclusion. Also, everyday tasks might be a bit more challenging due to delays in motor skill development. This means that they might take longer to reach certain milestones compared to a typical child. This might include sitting, walking, holding a pencil, buttoning clothes, and playing sports, among other things. It doesn't mean that they won't be able to do all those things, they'll just take a little longer than other people to do so and probably need some extra support. Now, if you're expecting a baby, you might be asking yourself, is there a way to know if my baby has Down syndrome? If you really want to find out the risk of your baby having Down syndrome before birth, you might want to have a screening test done. Screening tests won't tell you for certain if your baby has Down syndrome, rather it will tell you if your baby has a high risk or a low risk of having this condition. It is completely up to you whether you want to perform these tests or not. You can choose what you think is best for your family based on your wishes, values, and beliefs. There is no right or wrong answer. If you decide to undergo screening, your doctor will request a few tests, such as blood tests and ultrasound scans. The blood tests measure different substances in the mother's blood that might indicate a higher risk of the fetus having Down syndrome, while the ultrasound checks the fetus for certain characteristics that have been more associated with this diagnosis. The doctor will then analyze the results of these tests, taking into account additional factors, like the mother's age, to determine the approximate risk of the fetus having Down syndrome. More recently, a new screening test has been developed, which allows the measurement of chromosomal material from the fetus that is circulating in the maternal blood. This test only requires a sample of the mother's blood and is normally done during the first trimester of pregnancy. If the screening test is negative, that means the baby has a low chance of having Down syndrome. However, if it's positive, that means their risk is considered high. Remember, there are no screening tests that will tell you for sure whether the baby definitely has Down syndrome or not. So what should you do if your baby has a positive screening test for Down syndrome? Again, that is completely up to you. Some parents might not want to do anything at all, while others will choose to perform a diagnostic procedure which will tell you for sure whether the baby has Down syndrome. These tests require putting a needle into the placenta to remove a sample of tissue or taking a sample of fluid from inside the uterus. Because they are both invasive procedures, they carry a small risk of up to 1% of causing a spontaneous miscarriage. On the other hand, they are capable of telling you for sure if your baby has a chromosomal condition. If Down syndrome was not identified during pregnancy and the baby appears slightly different from other newborns upon birth, healthcare professionals may suspect Down syndrome based on the baby's appearance. They will then take a blood sample from the baby and conduct a chromosomal analysis, known as a karyotype, to confirm the diagnosis. So now we're going to chat about some health complications and associated conditions that people with Down syndrome might face throughout their lives. It's super important for them to have regular medical checkups to catch any issues early on and manage them properly. Around half of all individuals with Down syndrome have congenital heart defects. These can range from mild to severe and often affect the walls that separate the chambers of the heart. Sometimes they might even need surgery. So keeping an eye on heart health with regular cardiologist visits is crucial. People with Down syndrome can also develop blood cell abnormalities, including a form of blood cancer called leukemia. Plus, their immune system may not function properly, making them more prone to infections, certain types of cancer, and autoimmune conditions. Reflux disease and constipation can also occur. Sometimes they might even need surgery if their digestive organs are abnormally formed and obstruct the gastrointestinal tract. Celiac disease can be a challenge too. This is an autoimmune condition that affects their ability to absorb nutrients and makes them intolerant to a protein called gluten. The good news is that a healthy diet and monitoring by a healthcare provider can help manage these conditions. Now let's talk about sleep. Up to 75% of individuals with Down syndrome can have sleep apnea, which causes interrupted breathing during sleep. Also, they're at higher risk for hormonal problems. Difficulty producing thyroid hormone is common, leading to a condition called hypothyroidism that can impact growth, metabolism, and overall well-being. Plus, they have a higher risk of developing type 1 diabetes, which requires insulin injections throughout their lives. You might be surprised to learn that people with Down syndrome can have skeletal problems because of their super flexible joints. It might not sound like a big deal, but it can lead to pain or, in extreme cases, dislocation of the bones of the spine that can result in paralysis. Lastly, we should mention vision problems, hearing loss, and behavioral and psychological issues. Roughly 1 in every 14 children with Down syndrome also fall under the umbrella of autism spectrum disorders. While these might not be life-threatening, they can still have a significant impact on their quality of life and should be appropriately managed as they emerge. As for the case with most genetic disorders, there is no cure for Down syndrome. However, people with Down syndrome can benefit from some amazing therapies that can really help improve their lives. Speech therapy can greatly enhance communication skills, making it easier for those with Down syndrome to express themselves and understand others. Occupational therapy focuses on mastering everyday tasks, from getting dressed to preparing meals. Physical therapy can also be very important, as it helps to improve strength, balance, coordination, and mobility, enabling individuals with Down syndrome to participate more fully in physical activities and become more independent. Additionally, educational interventions can support learning and cognitive development. All of these therapies can be tailored to each person's individual needs, making them highly effective. With consistent work and support, they can empower people with Down syndrome to lead more independent and fulfilling lives. Let's talk about some of the things you can do to care for a person with Down syndrome. When it comes to supporting someone with Down syndrome, communication and patience are key. Make sure you use simple, easy-to-understand language and give them time to process what you're saying. Encourage them to share their thoughts and feelings and really listen to them. Don't forget that things like facial expressions and gestures also matter, so be mindful of those too. If you're helping them learn a new skill, break it down into smaller steps, show them how it's done, and use visual aids if needed. This way, they'll become more independent and confident. Now let's talk about social skills and keeping a healthy lifestyle. Get them involved in group activities like sports or clubs so they can make friends and practice their social skills. Be patient and supportive as they navigate the social world and offer guidance when needed. To help them stay healthy, get them involved in meal planning and cooking and encourage a balanced diet. Make sure physical activity is part of their daily routine too. By focusing on communication, independence, social skills, and a healthy lifestyle, you'll be making a big difference in the life of someone with Down syndrome. If you want some extra help to navigate the challenges of living with Down syndrome, be sure to check out organizations, support groups, and educational programs in your community. You can also find lots of reliable resources and information online from Down syndrome organizations all over the world. Now here's something special. Thanks to medical advancements, the future of a child born with Down syndrome is looking more promising each day. Taking a trip down memory lane, back in 1910, a child with Down syndrome was only expected to live until about 9 years old. This is quite shocking, isn't it? As time went on, things luckily started to change. In the 1980s, the life expectancy increased to 25 years, and here's the exciting part. Today, with cutting-edge treatments and innovations, especially heart surgeries, around 80% of adults with Down syndrome reach the age of 60, and many live even longer. Individuals with Down syndrome are also achieving huge personal and professional success. They have graduated college, started their own businesses, competed in the Olympics, became artists, models, actors and actresses, and the list goes on and on. With the right support and encouragement from their loved ones, the possibilities are endless. Now that's all for today's video. Thanks for watching, and remember, the journey of a person with Down syndrome is a scenic route filled with unexpected joys and unforgettable triumphs, teaching us the power of love, determination, and the strength in being different. See you next time. This video is part of Kenhub's limited clinical series and is for educational purposes only. It does not provide medical advice, and none of the information in this video should be used as an alternative to a medical exam, specialist diagnosis, nor treatment.